Amen.
Who are connected to this month of grace. From wherever you may be, the word of God and the truth of Jesus will break through. You will be saturated today with the amazing grace, love, and blessing of the Lord. The peace of Christ will never depart from you. As you march through this period of evil and disaster, the mighty pillar of fire will continue to stay with you. You will never become a victim. Whatever you may be going through, the Lord will tear through your body and expunge them out.
Amen.
By the possession of the Lord, we have appreciation and thanks and congratulations from the state evangelist, from the usual evangelist, and also from our pastor, from the pastor in Nigeria. May all their prayers and well wishes today, in the name of Jesus, saturate our lives.
Amen.
All the shepherds, one after the other, called to congratulate this parish. We thank the Lord for them. We thank the Lord for ourselves.
Thank you, Lord.
The Lord will saturate us with His mercy.
Amen.
It's precisely 25:1. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We are covering our nose. I also put on the shield that I was suffocated. And it was already affecting my heart. And I took the shield off. And that is the situation with God. Our lifestyle, our mindset, what we are doing, had not become an abomination stinking to the Lord. The Lord had to cover his nose so that he could not smell any longer. And he sent the message to you and to me to let you know how he's feeling about the world. We are stinking. Even the first, second, third centuries that didn't even experience the presence of Christ, they were better off. It is a generation of perverseness, a adulterous generation, a careful and reckless generation. Nobody speaking the truth again. Truth is lost. Righteousness has been sacrificed. All are in pursuit of vanity. In the name of Jesus, we will not go with the vanity of the world.
Amen.
He says in Isaiah 19:25, I will bless you. Egypt is my people, and my people. Assyria, the work of my hand.
The Lord of hosts shall bless.
Yes.
Say. Blessed be Egypt, my people.
Blessed be Egypt, my people.
And Assyria, the work of my
hand. And Assyria, the work of my hand.
And Israel, my inheritance.
And Israel, my possession. When you are the possession of the Lord, no matter what you do, he will smack you, he will knock you, he will flog you, he will tear you down, but he will never forsake you.
Thank
you will
Lord.
Never be forsaken.
Amen.
As a possession of the Lord, whatever you seek, whatever you're asking for, the Lord will grant them unto you.
Amen.
You will not live lives of vanity.
Amen.
The lesson learned to us today, once again, I thank our Father, the shepherd of Robot in Michigan, I restrained him from coming. He said, voice of grace and part and part. I brought him there, driving 13 hours to come here. Sleepless night, taking care of himself in the hotel, and coming in for this convocation. He's the state evangelist also of Michigan, Ohio, and far. And now, at this presence over there, the church has been spreading. The Lord will continue to reinforce our ministry.
Amen.
He will never do it in vain.
Amen.
I thank also my brother, my friend, Baba Samademayo, the executive director of fundraising, the man who raised over 110 for us, all within 15 minutes in the convention, also in charge of welfare. In the name of Jesus, we will continue to prosper.
Amen.
All your walls will be decorated.
Amen.
I thank you, my sister. precious daughter, Mother Celestial Bumi Adebayo, who also is the deputy director of the Central Choir.
And
the Lord will recognize you.
Amen.
And will decorate you.
Amen.
With the crown. I love all you people. Thank you so much. And I thank you all members of VOG. You are peculiar people. You are loving. You are caring. But you have a congregation where peace reigns, where love reigns, where oneness reigns. Just bless that congregation and continue to pray for them every day. You will never lose your possession.
Amen.
You are dearly beloved. You carry the load of 1,000 people and you are not weary. You will never be tired.
Amen.
You will never be tired.
Amen.
Those who will tear us apart will never know their way to this place.
Amen.
We are moving into greater glory.
Amen.
As we are here now, also at instant convocation, we shall see ourselves, because there's no coronavirus in heaven, we shall embrace ourselves. We shall taste the best dishes. We shall drink the red wine. We shall rejoice. And the glory of the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
Anytime I say red wine, people become. Just wait. Be patient. Hallelujah. Christ said, I will open my mouth, and I will not bring your God of the eating from the foundation of the world. The lesson left to us today, both the first and the second, they both have to do with end and harvest. The first lesson, taken from the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 11, verse 1, 2, 3, 4. Cast your bread upon the water, upon the sea. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Cast your bread upon the sea, and you will recover it after many days. What? It's a proverb. Allegory. What are we talking when we talk of sea or river? This same Solomon says in Ecclesiastes chapter 1 verse 7. Ecclesiastes chapter 1 verse 7.
All the rivers run into the sea.
All the rivers run into the sea.
Yet the sea is not full.
Yes.
Unto the place from whence the rivers come.
From where the river came.
There they return again.
They are returning. There is no referring to sea or river. It's referring to the world. Every day we have new babies coming, and the world is not filled. As some are coming, some are departing. They come and they go back. The world cannot be full. Yes. And he said, put your food. What is your food? Your meat. Christ says in John 4:34, he said, my food, my meat, is to do the will of him that has sent me. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Your meat is the will of him that has sent me to the world. It's the purpose of your being in the world. He said, cast that will. What the Lord has meant from you, sow it. Because at the end of the day, you will get fruits. Yes.
Give a portion to seven.
And a portion to eight.
Not what evil shall be upon the earth.
God bless you.
Amen.
That is the crux we want to talk. This young will, your meat, your food, the will of the Lord for you on earth. What the Lord wants you to do, let your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. That will, what the Lord is expecting from you, I classify it to the octagon of salvation. And because of the time constraint, I will just run the summary of it. These 8 points. When you are in school, you cannot say, say because you are doing arithmetic, you have actually gotten your point. You have arithmetic, you have geography, you have English, you have religious knowledge, you have also. When you get to the college also, same thing, you must satisfy the exam. In my own discipline, I don't know what happens in science. My own discipline, because you can, before you can be chartered or satisfied, on five levels, you must satisfy the examining board in financial management, in financial accounting, in cost accounting, in management accounting, in industrial law, in commercial law, in taxation, in auditing. About 10, 12 in five levels. You have to satisfy them in all those areas before you can now be said, be considered a charter or something. They take you years that you must pass, you must achieve success in each of the subjects. Exactly the same thing with God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Before you can actually be considered a righteous person, he said, cast your lot into eight lots, 7 to 8. The first one is your worship before the Lord. You must worship God in the first one. It says in Exodus 3:6, I've released my children so that they can worship me. The time is going. Release my children, Israel, so that they can worship me on this mount. It says, also in Deuteronomy 10:12, you must worship me with all your strength and your might. The Lord is not joking with worshiping. He says unto the angel in Revelation 4:8-10, read that. And please read Luke chapter 1, verse 73. Yes. The four beasts
had each of them 6 wings above him.
Yes.
And they were full of eyes.
Yes.
And they rest not day and
they
night.
They don't rest day and night.
Saying,
say,
holy,
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 Lord God Almighty,
Lord God Almighty,
which was, and is, and is to come.
Yes.
And when those beasts give glory and honor and thanks to him that sat on the throne,
yes,
who liveth forever and
yes,
ever. The 24 elders fall down before him,
yes,
that sat on the throne,
yes,
and worship him,
and worship him,
that liveth forever,
that liveth forever and ever,
and cast their crowns
before him, and
say, thou art worthy,
you are worthy to be worshipped,
to receive glory,
to receive all the glory and honor,
and power,
and power,
for thou hast created all things,
for thou hast created all things,
and for thy pleasure,
for your
they
pleasure,
are and were created.
You have created everything for your pleasure. He says in Isaiah 43:7, the man I've created him for my glory. When he says man, he means also woman. And they shall read on Taylor, you say, you should read that. He said, over there, there's no Jew or Gentile. There's no she or he. All are the same. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And the second lesson says, in verse 7, look from verse 6-7.
Angel flying in the midst of heaven.
Yes.
Having the everlasting gospel to preach unto them,
yes,
that dwell on the earth.
Yes.
And to every nation.
Preaching to every nation.
And kindred.
And kindred.
And tongue.
And tongue.
And people.
People.
Saying with a loud voice.
Yes.
Fear God.
Fear God.
And give glory to
give
him.
Give glory to him.
For the hour of his judgment is come.
Yes.
And worship him.
And worship him.
That made heaven
that
and earth.
Made heaven and earth. Worship him. That is the most important thing before the Lord.
Hmm.
It says in Luke chapter 1, verse 73, I'm sending Christ down because of what?
The oath which he swore to our father Abraham.
Yes.
That he would grant unto us.
That he grant unto us.
That we being delivered out of the hand of
our enemies. When you are delivered from your own, the hands of your enemies, because you are very enemies. When you see people, some witches, they it's not. They are weak. They are constricted. When you ask them to pronounce their cup out, they are frightened because they feel they will be killed. those in fraternity of darkness. Your goal is Angelite. And I'm saying it very, very loudly. When you ask them to come out, they are afraid because they have been initiated. And they feel if they come out, they'll be killed. Can you read Isaiah 59? Oh, just hold up. 59, verse 15, 16.
Yay.
Yay.
Truth faileth. And he that departeth.
Truth has failed. Yes.
And he that departeth from evil.
And he that has departed from witchcraft.
Maketh himself a prey.
He made himself a prey. They will kill him.
And the Lord saw it.
When they said him, come out of wizardry, come out of witchcraft, they fear they will be killed. Truth has been buried. Yes.
And the Lord saw it.
And the Lord saw it.
And it displeased him.
It displeased him.
That there was no judgment.
Yes. Continue.
That there was no judgment.
No judgment.
And he saw that there was no man.
No man.
And wondered that there was no intercessor.
No intercessor.
Therefore his arm.
Yes.
Therefore his arm brought salvation unto him.
His arm himself decided to deliver these people.
And his righteousness,
yes,
it sustaineth him.
Yes. Yes.
That he would grant unto us.
That he would grant unto us.
That we, being delivered out of
the hand. He will deliver you from the hand of those who hate you. The witches,
amen,
the wizards. Even if you are there, the Lord will remove you from there.
Amen.
Yes.
That we might serve him without fear.
So that you can serve him without fear.
Yes.
In holiness.
In holiness.
In righteousness.
In righteousness. All the days of your life. The point is, if you are released and you don't serve God, they will kill you. The purpose of the Lord coming to release you is for you to worship him. When you worship God, the power of God will continue to enjoy the second one commandment of the Lord. The first one is worshiping God. The second one is commandment of the Lord. You all know that when this was delivered on Mount Sinai, in Exodus 20. You all know you don't read it. And you have all read from Deuteronomy chapter 10, 13 from 10 to 15, that these commandments have not been taken from the sea or from heaven. There's something that you can comply with because those are the attributes of Christ that he says in Galatians 3:23. Those are the, if you want to live in Christ, you must abide in these commandments. If anybody is saying the commandments are not important, they are meant for hell. Because a number of people say it's great. I found somebody preaching before said, we are no longer Mount Sinai. We are not Mount Zion. Mount Sinai is where the commandments came in. Mount Zion is where we have grace. It was rubbish. When you do something and you want to justify it, you are even destroying your heaven.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Christ says in Luke chapter 5 verse 17. I'm sorry. Matthew 5 17 and Luke 16 17.
That I am come to destroy the law.
I have not come to destroy the law.
Or the prophets.
Yes.
I am not come to destroy.
Yes.
But to fulfill.
Then to fulfill.
But verily I say unto you,
I say unto you,
till heavens and earth pass,
and not pass,
one jot or one tittle shall no wise pass from the law till all be fulfilled.
Every commandment of the law must be fulfilled.
Amen.
We are reading Luke 16:17.
It is easier for heaven and earth to pass.
It is easier. Speak louder, please.
It is easier for heaven and earth to pass.
Yes.
Than one title of the law to fail.
Than for any part of the law to
fail. Fail.
It tells us in 1 Timothy chapter 1 from verse 6, 7, 8, those who are still committing sins, who are not obeying commandments, they are not subject to grace. They can't have the grace of Christ. You must submit to the commandments of God. It is important. Number 3, time is going. Please go into faith. Christ says in Matthew 23:23. I'm taking it in according to their import of their relevance.
Woe unto you. Strike the Pharisees.
Yes.
Hypocrites.
For you pay tithes of mint.
You pay tithes, you think that is the most important.
I'm coming and
You are tithers. No. Yes.
And you have omitted the weightier matters of the law.
The weightier matters of the law.
Judgment.
Mercy. Which is the commandment of God? Judgment. Because you know, at the end of the day, in Revelation 11:18, you see that when the judgment day comes, what was the temple of God? Was the ark containing the Ten Commandments. Continue.
Mercy.
Start again.
Woe unto you, Pharisees and scribes, hypocrites.
Woe to the Pharisees, yes.
For you pay tithes of mint and anise and cumin and have omitted the weighty matters of the law.
That is the most important, yes.
Judgment.
Mercy.
And faith. These ought ye to have done.
Faith. Without faith, you can never please God. Say, without faith in Hebrews 11:6, you can never be pleasing to God. He promised those who left Egypt for redemption unto the promised land. He says in Hebrews 3, verse 11:18, because you don't have faith, every one of them perished.
And to whom swear he that they should not enter into his rest?
Yes.
But to them that believe not?
Yes, those who believe not. The Lord said they will not enter into his rest. Yes.
So we see that we could not enter in because of unbelief.
Because of faithlessness, you cannot enter into the kingdom of God. You can't enter into the kingdom of God. By faith, you must know God is existing. By faith, you must know that the power stretching out the heavens and the earth, almighty power. By faith, you must know that whatever your problem is, that God is able to resolve. If you don't have faith, God is not interested in you. And you are not returning the waiting time. And he says in Luke 21:19, in your waiting, you possess your possession. Without faith, you cannot please God. You can't. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Faith is so critical. Faith is so important. You have to be patient. You have to be patient. The Lord will use tribulation and waiting to try your faith. You will pray. You may pray for years, and it seems God is not answering. It seems God is asleep. It seems God has abandoned you. No, he has not. You must continue. Sister Cecil gave a message some 2 Sundays ago. He said, when you pray for years and nothing is happening, you have 2 options. Either to say, I'm fed up, I'm leaving God, and you surrender to Satan. Or you stay with God and say, I'm not a living sacrifice. Do whatever pleases you in my life. So when you say, you are fed up, I've been waiting, I've been praying, I've been doing this, remember that the entire world is nothing before the Lord. He says in Isaiah 40, is less than nothing before him. And all the mighty people are less than grasshoppers before him. So you must understand the God that giving, he doesn't even know that I exist. After the entire world has been washed away, perished, almost a year, the Lord then said, God remembered Noah. After he has destroyed the entire world, he has forgotten. He has gone to another assignment. After almost a year, and God remembered Noah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So whatever you are, worship God, keep the commandments of God, and remain faithful in the Lord. And the first one is love. You all know what love is. 1 Corinthians 13 is stated everything. Even if you are an angel, you do not love, you are wasted. Individual. Even if you can prophesy, you don't have love, it is absolutely useless to the Lord. If you can pray and move the mountains, the Lord said, you are nothing before him unless you have love. If you can preach and convert, if you don't have love, it is a waste before the Lord. So love is very critical. When you love, there must be any malice in you. When you have love, you must be far from anger. When you have love, love is a lifestyle of sacrifice, not of selfishness.
Ben.
You offer your life, your comfort, your pleasure. So love is the fourth, and they are very critical. And all these, this man was preaching. So he gave a revelation that he saw a skullcap. And he saw some people in their skullcap. In faith, they have almost zero. In giving, they are high. In this, they have this. Scorecard. 8 points.